so excited. I've been wanting to share my DIY traveler's notebooks for since I started making them and using them after watching the Reset Girl and her videos on decorating covers and using them for Lister's Got a List challenge. And these are the three that I have been using for quite a while. And this one is a painted fabric that I altered with embroidery, and I glittered it up and stitched some on the sewing machine. So this one was the first one that I made just with materials that I already had at home after, of course, ordering the eyelet setter, which I had to have. So I just wanted to try how it felt to make one, and I really like this one. But then I found in a furniture shop here this placemat, which is like plastic, that I, first of all, I really like this colors and the cover, and pink is my favorite color, so I decided to buy a couple of those, and I made this one. It does not have the eyelets, so I made two of those. This is in a field notes pocket size. So tiny and cute. And this is the regular size, which was what I was first fascinated by and really fell in love with. So I thought I'd share the content of this one in this first video. Here on the side you can see my charms. This is a kimono with some knots that I got from a friend. And my favorite of all times, little charm. This is a softy monkey representing the monkey mind, and the reason why I absolutely need to have a notebook with me at all times. When I made this, I just found this orange little charm, and I don't know, it's just been left there because I haven't been I've been too lazy to exchange this, but it's kind of cute. And I think orange goes well with pink. It's my favorite color combination right now, so that's good. And when we open it up, the back side of the placemat was white, so I covered it with gold foil plastic. And I added in a pocket for my business cards. They are from Moo. And all of them have different collages on the outside. And inside I have a couple of notebooks and some folders and stuff. And I thought I'd go through it so that you can see. And for those that are super new to Traveler's Notebooks, it consists of a cover with holes at the top and the bottom where you have string these plastic ribbons. You have four in the spine, and you just find the middle of a notebook that fits inside it and slip those in. And there are different ways that you can have more than just the four, or some come with two, but I made mine with four. And then at the spine there is one hole, or at some traveler's notebooks has one hole here, and then this closure that sticks out so that you can fasten everything in so that it's protected at both this side and all around. And for me this has been a really fun system to play with, and that is a traveler's notebook. There are plenty of tutorials online, so I'm not going to go into more on how to set your up, but just show you what's inside of mine. All of these I have in some way made myself, so this is all DIY ideas that you can copy and do on your own, from the cover if you manage to find this kind of PVC plastic somewhere, to the notebooks. This one is a board notebook which has just plain lines. I didn't really feel like I needed it in A5, so I just decided to cut it down and then round each corner. I numbered each page like so, and I have set this up to be a blog planner for the past 2 years. Before that I blogged for like 10 years without having a blog planner, so I haven't really been using this. I'm an old dog when it comes to blogging and new to YouTube, so please forgive any mistakes that I do, but this is how I just started it, by noting down some questions that you can ask before you write your blog post, gluing in some photos of me at the office, some ideas on what I want my blog to be, and things to do each day. A very elaborate schedule that I never followed, but it's good to have some kind of idea on what you want to post each day, so that you have a theme in your mind at least. So I also printed my about page that I need to rewrite. So it starts here and then it goes on to be this description of me and what I do. There are a couple of opt-in ideas that I've collected and really like. The one I already made and launched on my blog is printable quotes for your notebook that you get when you sign up for my newsletter. I'm really proud of those. Then I have blog post ideas, which is what this notebook was supposed to be about, but I just make these lists everywhere. I have more ideas than I ever will have time, so it's not a problem for me. These are a couple of hashtags that I made up for what I use on Instagram, which I think is quite fun when you start to use a hashtag on your own and you can see your own history. My favorite one is the Pink Flower Mission, which is like 2 years old. I think someone else has started to post to this because it just comes up when you write pink flower now, but it's my invention and I had a mission to just document every pink flower that I came across, and it was fun. Plugins that I have tried, plugins that I want to try, wish list for blog, more blog posts that I want to write, some stats about the swap that I host, and lots of blank pages, more stats, and that's it for that little notebook made by Bird. And then I have like a little plastic folder that I can't remember where it comes from, but it's not made for the Traveler's Notebook. I just found it somewhere in my stash and I have been using it for these printables that I cut out. They're all from the internet, free on the internet or Pinterest, and stuff that I found. I think all of these, most of these at least, are pinned on my Pinterest board that is called Printables, in case you want to go check them out. And print, I use these are just on regular paper, so I use a glue stick to add them into anywhere I want in my notebooks where I'm working. There's sticker sheets and fun stuff like that in here, and no special order, some washi tape sampler that I think these are from someone else's stash, and sometimes I make them from my own stash, but if I see a friend that has a lot of washi tape, I like to let them make one of these of my tapes and I can make one of theirs, so it's fun to have some variation with the washi tape, and good to have on the go instead of all the older rolls that you can bring. And my second insert in this book, as you can see, is on the third rubber band. It's a book that I made. It's called The Brain Dump. And I think a traveler's notebook or any notebook should have a place for brain dumping things. And as you can see, this is dated 2 years ago also when I started this, but I haven't really filled it since I've also been carrying this, the smaller size traveler's notebook in the same style that I made, and this has been in my handbag, and this brain dump is almost full. So this is a notebook that I made. Here you can see a printable that I made as the first page, which is of my pink flower mission that you can find on Instagram. So it's really neat. And the cover is just a scrapbook paper. And the spine of this particular notebook is sewn on my mom's sewing machine. I couldn't really figure it out on my own, so she helped me. And it has been working really well for this notebook. And you can also see that this notebook has been in my bag quite a bit. It's looking like someone chewed it, but it's just torn and worn from being in my bag when I'm up and about. So that's how it looks on top. And let's have a look inside. So the middle cover is this washi tape collage. It just samples most of my older washi tapes. Just showing what I had at some point. Most of these are still there in my stash, but this one just ran out when I was at a cafe. The little rose one is one of my favorite washi tapes. So, no more roses in my stash. So anyway, let's start with just a glue-in plastic sleeve with some cutouts of movies that I want to see and my Mo business cards of my collage on one side, and some information about me and my shop on the other side. Always good to bring a couple of those in case you meet someone who's interested, and then an index that is not updated. So the brain dump notebook insert starts with a explanation of what rapid logging and brain dump can be, and what bullet journaling can be about, which is also something I have been experimenting with. So movie scene, and a couple more movies, and then you just forget the list and forget to update it, and then it's no longer in use. And movies that I might want to check out someday. I've seen the trailer or I've seen something about it and I want to check it out. So that's what this is. This is an old printable from my DIY calendar with TV series that I want to see. So I've actually seen all of these except for House of Cards. I don't know, should I watch that one? I haven't seen it. But the other ones I have... I have already watched. Since we got Netflix, it's so easy and fun to watch TV series. And books I want to check out. This book is made out of like printables where I this is a dot grid, and later on you'll see I've got a couple of pages of this grid, square grid, and then I also added in the dot grid that is blank on one page, so it's kind of different papers inside. And then wish lists, blog post ideas. I wrote a blog post about the genius idea of the traveler's notebook system, which you can check out. So this is a follow-up about my own
Traveler's Notebook DIY stuff, embroidery ideas, stuff and notes. I got some quotes that I liked and wanted to take note of. And I think that's it for this notebook. It's a couple of blank pages left. At the back, I always add in an envelope of some kind, transparent or some regular envelope thingy that I so that I can keep stuff with this notebook that I want to glue into it. And that's this one. This is like an extremely flimsy and irritating thing that I made. I just took an ordinary plastic sleeve, sewed down the middle and cut it to so that you can use it as a folder in this, but I'm gonna throw this away as soon as I find or make a replacement. These are also some washi tape samplers, which I like to have on the go. So I should use these more. These are really cute. The succulent and some watercolor patterns. And polka dot tapes from my friend, which I really like. Here's the back of the pouch with some owl puppy stickers that I got from a Happy Mail. And they're so cute. And more fun washi tape. You can never have too much washi tape. You can never have too many notebooks. And this is the last insert. I also made this one with just a simple scrapbook paper cover and some pink pages inside. I call these randomosity notebooks, and they're kind of scrapbook memory keeping, just for fun, doing cute stuff, adding in ephemera and stuff. And since this video is so long already and I'm showing so much, I thought I'd do a flip through of this one in a later video. It's just almost filled, so it's just like some writing left to do on the last page, and then I'm going to start on a new one. So when it's finished, I thought I'd do a flip through of this one too. So that's what is inside of my regular sized traveler's notebook that I made by myself. And I hope you liked this little flip through, and that you will hit subscribe, and I will show a lot of my other notebooks in upcoming videos. So talk to you soon. Thanks for subscribing and watching. And if you have any questions, please let me know below. And I will try to answer as best as I can. Bye bye.